10% of the fuel we use has to come from renewable energy. A big percentage of that quota comes from biofuels. Great for the environment and domestically produced, they reduce our reliance on foreign fuel imports.
MEPs want to cap crop-based biofuel production to 5.5% of their 2020 renewable energy goals and promote new generation biofuels such as algae. But can they really strike the balance that helps the industry and the environment?
Traditional food-based biofuels generate lots of greenhouse gases, and with farmland used for fuel and not for food, it's increasing demand and reliance on imports. Faustine Defosé is an environmentalist who says reform of the bio industry is crucial.
If we follow the member states' projections, by 2020 we'll have the equivalent of an additional between 14 and 29 million of cars in terms of emissions on EU roads.
So it seems that biofuels, at least the first generation of them, aren't the environmentally sound alternative to fossils we once thought. But the next generation of biofuel technology may be. However, it's a complex pathway to arriving there.
Il faut en même temps réduire la part des aliments qui servent à faire de l'essence. Chacun peut comprendre ça. Dans le même temps, stabiliser les industries parce qu'il y a de l'emploi et dans le même temps encourager les nouvelles technologies sur des agrocarburants avancés.
But the industry needs time and incentive to switch over to new generation biofuels.
There were people who invested in biodiesel. You need to leave them time, you know, to pay back basically their investments. We did commit a study to check when investments for biofuels will be paid back. Nice. And our study come with the end of 2017.
The big vote on biofuels takes place next Wednesday, but with environment and industry committees at odds over the cap on first generation biofuels, could we be in for a bumpy ride? Just like these corns, it's all aboard to Strasbourg to find out.